Hello, my dear students. A very pleasant morning to all of you. So today we are going to continue with the topic of typing text. When we are ready to type in the text area of Microsoft Word, a flashing vertical line will appear on the screen. So that flashing vertical line is called the cursor. Okay, this is the cursor. This flashing vertical line is called the cursor. So when you will start typing anything using a keyboard into your monitor screen, into your computer, you will see that this line will appear on the screen. This line is called the cursor. What is this called, students? This flashing vertical line is called the cursor. So here you will see that the person have written already 4 lines. Now he want to write the 5th line. Then you will see a cursor will appear on the screen. From here you can start typing your text. So the cursor indicates where the text will begin from, where you will start writing. As we reach at the end of the line while typing the text, the cursor will automatically move down to the next line. For example, if you are started writing a line, already you have written this much line. Now you have already reached the end of the line. After there, there is no space. Then you will see that automatically the cursor will go to the next line, and here the vertical line will be moved. So that feature of MS Word is called a wrap, word wrap. Again, let me explain you. You have already started writing from here and you have reached till the end of your line. Now there is no space of writing further. Then automatically your cursor will move to the next line. Here you will see the cursor now. So you should begin now writing from the next line. So you will move down to the next line. That feature of Microsoft Word is called a word wrap. What it is called, students? Word wrap. We will press enter only when we want to change a paragraph. Directly after finishing or after reaching the end of the line, the cursor will automatically move down to the next line. But when you want to change the paragraph, you should press the enter key. For example, you have start writing, but you want to write up till here only. After that, you want to start writing a next paragraph. Then you have to press the enter key from the keyboard, and without reaching the end of the line, your cursor will be moved down so that you can write the next paragraph. We can use a backspace key or the delete key from the keyboard to delete the character before the cursor, and delete key to delete the character after the cursor. Okay, so what is the difference between the backspace key and the delete key? The backspace key will delete the word before the cursor. For example, here your cursor is. When you will press the backspace key, the character before the cursor will get deleted. But when you will press the delete key from the keyboard, the word after the cursor will get deleted. Okay, so if you want to delete the character before the cursor, you should press the backspace key. But if you want to delete the character after the cursor, you should press the delete key. Let us see the keys we use to move the cursor on the screen. First is arrow key, that is up arrow key, down arrow key, left key or right key. It will move around the document. If you want to go up, you should press the up key. If you want to go down, you should press the down arrow key. If you want to go left, you should press the left arrow key. If you want to go right, you should press the right arrow key. Let us see that how this arrow key will look. This is the up arrow key. This is the down arrow key. This is the right arrow key. And this is the left arrow key. So if you want to go on the left hand side, you should press this key. If you want to go on the right hand side, you should press this key. If you want to go up, you should press this key. And if you want to go down, you should press this key. Next is page up or page down key. Like that it would be presented in the keyboard, page up and page down. If you want to go up in the document or if you want to move down in the document, you should press this key. It will move your screen up or down. Next is home key. The home key will lead you to the beginning of the line. For example, if you have already written 5 lines, again you want to go to the first line, then by pressing the home key, you will reach at the beginning of the line, that is here. Next is end key. For example, if you have written many lines and you are at the top position, You want to go at the end of your line, then you should press the end key and you will reach here at the end of the line. Next is control plus home, that will lead you to the beginning of your document. And last is control plus end, that will lead you to the end of your document. Okay, so these are the keys which is used to move around the document, to move your screen up and down, to go to the beginning of the line, to go to the end of the line, to move to the beginning of the document, and to move to the end of the document. Okay, so with this we are finishing our session today. We will see about how to create a new document in our next class. Okay, so let us quickly revise what we have studied today. So first we have seen how to type a text, how to write a paragraph, how to delete a character using a backspace key and the delete key, and also we have seen about some important keys of the keyboard. So now we will continue with how to create a new document in our next class. For now, bye bye, have a great day ahead.